Hi, I'm Ed Fritz, the owner of AtticFoil.com, and I'm calling this video the Mega Installation Video. In the next 15 minutes, I'm going to give you all the information you need to know about stapling up AtticFoil brand radiant barrier in your attic. I'm going to cover the basics, answer the most common questions, and give you some tips and tricks to make your job go fast and easy. This is about a 15-minute video, and it's in three parts, and I guarantee you'll learn more in the next 15 minutes than if you spend hours searching elsewhere.
First, I want to talk about the big picture. People tend to overthink things when it comes to installing a radiant barrier. Here are the only two things you really need to focus on. First, cover as much area as possible. The more coverage, the better the result. But don't go crazy and spend hours trying to get some small, hard-to-reach area down in the corner of your attic. Installing radiant barrier has a cumulative effect. We want to get the big open areas first and worry about the small, hard-to-reach areas later. Secondly, air should flow through the attic as though the foil really isn't even there. Ideally, air should come through the bottom of the attic in through the soffit vents and either run between the foil and the roof deck or be drawn to inside the attic. Hot air is all going to end up in the top of the attic one way or the other. Hot air kind of flows like water toward a drain. The key is you want to give it an unobstructed path to come in and go through the attic and then get out. Also, I want to talk about the true goal of installing a radiant barrier. Contrary to what's often promoted, the goal is to not cool down the air temperature inside the attic. Yes, that does tend to happen, but our true goal is to cool down the temperature of the insulation. Here's what happens. The sun heats up the roof. It can typically get to 180 degrees or more on the top shingles. And the bottom of the roof deck can easily be 150 degrees. Once the roof is hot, it's going to radiate heat across the attic and heat up the insulation. This is the definition of radiant heat, heat transfer by non-contact. The roof heats up the insulation without ever even touching it. It's not hot air in the attic that heats it up, it's the infrared radiation or heat being emitted by the roof that heats up the attic insulation. Radiant heat is the invisible part of the light spectrum. It travels at the speed of light until it's either absorbed or reflected. In a typical attic, the heat comes off the roof and is absorbed by the attic insulation. Typically, the top surface of the insulation can reach 130 degrees or more. This means that the top of the insulation is 130 degrees, and say the inside space where you're living, you want it to be 75 degrees. That's a 55 degree difference, which is called the delta T, and results in a lot of heat coming in the home. Many people will say, hey, just add more attic ventilation, which will help, but not so much. You can have great airflow through the attic, but it'll only drop the top surface temperature of the insulation a few degrees. This is kind of like blowing a fan on a hot, sunny driveway and expecting it not to get hot. It just doesn't work that way. Using the driveway as an example again, if the driveway is in the shade, then the concrete really can't get any hotter than the actual air temperature outside. The same thing happens right here between the roof and the insulation. We want to put the insulation in the shade, not from the light, but from the shade from the heat coming off the roof.
Since radiant heat can only either be absorbed or reflected, we can easily reflect the heat coming off the roof back towards the roof and keep the top surface temperature of the insulation cooler. After installing a radiant barrier, the top surface temperature should only be a few degrees warmer than the outside air temperature. This is how radiant barrier works, by reducing the delta T. If we can reduce the delta T, that means less heat is coming from the roof, through the insulation, and into the home. And less heat coming in means you have to spend less money to get the heat out, and the home will be more comfortable.